The number of dead is rising in a landscape that has been transformed, devastated. This is what is left after more than 250 times the average monthly rainfall came down in just 24 hours and cascaded onto Derna. Entire neighbourhoods swept away as two dams on the outskirts of the city failed.
A catastrophe hit Libya. A huge catastrophe. May God accept the victims. We pray for their families.
Despite the scale of the destruction, the hunt for survivors goes on. Some international help is arriving. These dogs are part of a Spanish rescue team involved in a search against the clock.
We've been working all day on the buildings that have been completely destroyed by the dams bursting. The scale of destruction in the city is devastating, with a huge number of buildings damaged and victims missing. That's why we are working as hard as we can.
People survey the little that's left with a sense of disbelief and with questions. Why weren't residents warned the storm was coming and given time to escape? Why weren't the dams maintained to a higher standard? On the water's edge, the grim task of looking for the bodies that were swept away into the sea. It may be some time before the true extent of the tragedy is known. The UN is talking of a calamity of epic proportions.
This incident is something that we never seen in Libya before. Unfortunately, it claimed thousands of lives, and still there's other thousands that are missing. All efforts are put now for rescue teams to try to be able to manage this disaster, but it's really challenging.
A challenge made even harder in a country that's governed by two rival groups. Libya's internationally recognised regime has launched an investigation, promising anyone whose actions or failure to act played a part in the dam's collapsing will be held accountable. But few here have confidence in the ability of those in power to respond adequately to the sheer scale of what's happened in a country ravaged by years of instability and chaos. Simon Jones, BBC News.